Şöyle. I feel dark as hell.
Okay, looks like we are live and direct. Good afternoon, everybody. Hope everybody's having an amazing day. My name is Ryan McCrary. I'm the CEO of McCrary Financial Solutions, where we provide financial solutions through financial literacy, entrepreneurship, and digital marketing. I'm joined by a great guest today. It's going to be a great conversation for you guys. I'll bring her on in 1 second, but I want to read her bio. So today we have Danielle D. Washington. She is the CEO and founder of Rogue Experiences, an amazing company. So this is a thriving group, travel concierge that teaches busy women of color how to pursue, how to push the pause button on life via unforgettable travel experiences. She also curates group travel and retreat experiences for entrepreneurs interested in adding an additional revenue stream to their business. Let me know if that's important, y'all. Put some comments down, put some likes down there. I see a few people jumping on. Do me a favor, y'all. Please share. Also, when you watch this on replay, type replay down in the chat. Type your name and where you are tuning in from. So, with over 20 years experience, she doesn't even look old enough to have 20 years experience. But with over 20 years experience in event planning, logistics, and hospitality, Danielle is skilled in curating a one-of-a-kind domestic and international excursions for groups and solo travelers. If you're a solo traveler, drop some comments down. If you like, I wanna, like me, when I used to be, a few years ago in my 20s, I used to wanna take a lot of trips, but a lot of my friends just, didn't wanna go where they didn't have the money. So, like, it's nothing wrong with that solo travel. But she proudly offers a variety of services that include guided group travel experiences, destination research, and booking, retreat planning, and detailed trip itineraries. Her main priority is helping her clients use travel as a way to live life on their own terms and immerse themselves in the freedom that comes along with that. So, without further ado, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well. Hello, hello, hello. Thanks for having me, Ryan. I'm greatly appreciative of being here.
You're welcome. So, before we even get started, so I mean, I did, say your long background, even though that was
That's a short version.
the short version. So just give people just a little bit more, of like what you do, travel, why travel, and just a little bit more about yourself.
Yeah, so for me, kind of a background, I will first start by saying I'm from San Francisco, California. I'm from the Bay. So if you hear a lot of hellas, don't be alarmed. I will say hello many times today, most likely. I've been traveling all my life. I think my first trip on a plane was at 3 months. My first passport was at five. And I lived abroad for several years. And so I've been able through life, been able to discover the joy that travel brings you, but also the need of travel, and especially as an entrepreneur, being able to kind of add that into your life. Rogue Experiences is really a kind of twofold. It we really focus on helping women of color, push the pause button, as you mentioned in my bio on life, because oftentimes we're so busy doing everything for everyone else. As entrepreneurs, we are always so busy doing everything for everyone else, our clients, that we don't take the time that we need to pause, recharge, and get back to being the great people that we are. And so that's really the focus behind what we do. So we do it for women of color, but we also do it for entrepreneurs who are looking to add events and group retreats to their company. So yeah, that's
That's
about it.
great. That is so exciting. So I see a few people jumping on. My man Dante just joined, a few other people. So do me a favor, y'all. Please share this out on your Facebook page, your personal page, your business page, put it in your group, put it on, tag some of your friends. This is an important conversation, especially for entrepreneurs, but other people, just to make more money, because the key to this is sustaining your energy so you have the right mindset to make more money and build your business, take care of your family, whatever the case may be. My book, of course, is about mindset and how mindset plays into how much money you can make, your income and business, stuff like that. So this is a great conversation. So, one of the questions I have is, people always ask me, what made you want to become an entrepreneur? Why did you want to become a business owner? Being a business owner is not for the weak. I feel like we're kind of the black sheep of the world. It's becoming, you know, a lot more mainstream and quote unquote cool to be an entrepreneur. But at the same time, you know, in these mainstream conversations and, you know, just dealing with people on a day-to-day basis, most people aren't entrepreneurs. So what made you want to do that and just want to be a business owner?
So that's funny, because I will be the first one to say being an entrepreneur is not cool. Like, some days I will, like when you're working late nights, I'm like, I wish I worked for the man. But knowing my spirit, I'm not meant to work for the man. That being said, how did I become an entrepreneur? My parents were both entrepreneurs. Both my parents owned a business. My first technical job, my parents had a cabin that we rented out to people. So when I was in elementary, I'm answering phones and telling people, oh my God, this place is amazing, da, 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 which is funny, kind of do that today. And, you know, helping them, you know, book that. My relatives were all entrepreneurs. And so I saw entrepreneurship, and I'll be the first one to admit, I did not want to be an entrepreneur because I saw how hard my parents worked. I actually ended up becoming an entrepreneur when I quit my corporate job. I was working for a subsidiary of Sony for about 7 or 8 years. And I just was tired. I was tired of doing the same thing. I was making a lot of money. I was traveling the world on someone else's dime and having a lot of fun, but I wasn't fulfilled. It just didn't fulfill me as a person. So I just quit. And I didn't have a plan. And someone's like, you should start blogging. And that's when I thought you could make money from blogging, which is a lie. So don't let anyone.
I heard a lot of people say they made a lot of money from blogging.
Yeah. When? In the 80s? Oh. Not the 80s.
I missed the blogging era. Like, I didn't become an entrepreneur until like 2015, 16.
Yes.
Before that, I knew nothing about online marketing, blogging. I've heard of it, but like, I missed that whole wave.
Yeah, the wave of blogging, when people made money off of blogging, was a while ago. It is not, I would say it was 2000, I don't know, anything before 2014, 13, I think that people were making a lot more money off of blogging. I think the ideal of blogging and making money off of it is dead. Maybe becoming more of an influencer is more kind of shifted from that. But anyway, I thought you could make money from blogging. And I'm like, oh, I'm going to do this blog and create a lifestyle blog. And I created a lifestyle blog, started off as Rogue Style Maven, see the kind of connection. And I realized I don't like writing about, I love fashion, I don't like writing about it. And it kind of morphed into, I was really passionate about helping women break out of their comfort zone, take care of themselves, and travel. Travel has been a huge part of my life and kind of morphed into what Rogue Experiences is today.
That is great. That is great. So do me a favor, y'all. Put some comments down. Put some likes down. If you got any questions you want to ask her about travel, you know, about a place that you're thinking about going to, she can give you a lot of insight on that. That's something I want to talk about as well. You know, as suggestions for people on where they should go, where they shouldn't go. You see a lot of things in the media or you hear stories, but this is a travel expert that can tell you where to go, where not to go. You know, when you go places, what you want to do there, and also just about business and, you know, making money in the travel industry. Mm-hmm. So the next question I have is, you know, why do you think traveling is so important? You know, number one, if you think travel is important, I would assume you think so. You know, I personally do. But why do you think it's so important? Because for me personally, like for me, it just gets my mind right. Like even now, like I went to the beach a few weeks ago, but like this summer, like I didn't really do much traveling. You know, we were in Atlanta in June, you know, came back from that trip. It wasn't even really necessarily a trip, but came back from that on fire. You know, I love being in different cities and, you know, meeting new people, getting out of the house, stuff like that. But like for me, I'm like, listen, I need to get out. You know, I need to go somewhere. I need to take a trip. I haven't really been anywhere in a few months. So like, why do you think that's so important? Number one, and, you know, tie into that, you know, what that does for your mindset and being, you know, able to unplug and clear your head so you can go out, take over the world, smash your business goals, your personal goals, your relationship goals. You know, what, you know, why do you think that's so important?
So I'm going to throw this back at you. When you didn't travel for how long is it? You didn't go to the, you went to the beach, but how long had it been before you took a vacation?
Years, 2-3 years, probably more.
And how did
I still... Yeah, like, you know, I consider that a vacation, but, you know, I still haven't had like a real, real vacation in like, probably like 4 years.
And how did that make you feel when you were on your trip? Like once you took time away from the business, because you grind hella hard. So when you took a second to breathe, how did that feel?
It made me feel a lot better because I could come in and just, you know, definitely be more creative in the business, you know, definitely could, you know, just get my mind right and focus more. And it just put me in a different space, honestly.
Yeah. And that's the reason why people need to travel. It's funny. I forgot the statistic and I'll put it in the comments, but like there's an amount that's like stupid crazy of how many vacation days Americans don't take.
Right.
And we don't take it because we feel guilty. We feel guilty because our coworkers, you know, may have to take over work. We feel guilty because our clients are doing something. As entrepreneurs, we feel guilty because we're supposed to grind so hard. I think we have this, as entrepreneurs, we have this hustle hard mentality. You hustle so hard that you hustle into diabetes because you're eating bad. You hustle into high blood pressure because you're not, you know, sleeping or eating right. There's all these different things. But studies have shown that if we just take a small pause in life to breathe, that you A, are more creative. Because if you've noticed, like when you're in the shower, the most random locations is when the ideals that—
Right, I get so many ideas in the shower.
Exactly, because you're taking the moment to pause. Imagine if you were intentional about taking these moments to pause, what that can do for your business. Mm. And that's why travel is so important.
Mm. Are y'all getting this? Are y'all listening to this? You know, I know a lot of people that don't even get out the city, damn near the state, you know, for years and years at a time. But it's like, it's so important. Make the investment, make the time. Because a lot of us, you know, we have the money. We just may not be allocating it, you know, correctly and something else. So, you know, just going out on the weekend, you know, every week in your city, just don't go out, you know, save your money. You can put that to a trip. Like literally, like me personally, I just spend a lot of money going out, going to the clubs, going to the bars, taking people out, all that type of stuff. And then I realized, honestly, I was like, all this money I'm spending, like, I could just put that on a flight. I could put that on, you know, a hotel or excursion when I get there, whatever the case may be. So this is so important.
And it's funny, the way I think about it is we choose what we spend our money on.
Right.
So we choose to go out to eat every day. We choose to go get that Starbucks, whatever. And like what I tell a lot of my clients is if you want to start having a travel fund or creating one, put aside some money, like have a separate account that, you know, if you have a paycheck that, you know, X amount of money goes into that travel fund that you don't even see. And so when you are ready to travel, you aren't looking like, you know, let's look at the credit card account. Let's see what we got. What's the balance here? So there's you doing that. You already know you have this fund that is considered your, you know, travel fund that you have already set aside.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so if you're just tuning in, guys, I'm talking to Danielle Washington. She is the CEO of Rogue Experiences, an amazing travel brand, an amazing entrepreneur. So before we do go further, I do want to ask you now, what are some places that you recommend to people? You know, everybody's talking about, you know, I don't know, Thailand or wherever. I want to go to Ibiza and stuff like that. But like, you know, just give people some suggestions on places that people may not be thinking about, that like they may be sleeping on, that they should definitely check out. They should definitely go places you've been, places you recommend.
So the way I see travel, and I tell this to people all the time, travel is like art. It is like in the eye of the beholder. What works for me may not be good for you. I've been to Ibiza. Don't plan to go back anytime soon in life. Really? But Ibiza might, no, I mean, it was fun. Well, minus the food poisoning I had, but that's not, that could happen anywhere. But Ibiza wasn't like my end all be all, but it might be that way for you. Like I love clubbing. Like I love going to Burning Man, which I know is not your thing. And if anyone knows about Burning Man, you can look it up. I don't need to explain it, but I, you know, it all varies on what you love, but there are places that are definitely trending. If you even think about it, a couple years ago, like when Obama was still in office, rest in peace, we miss Obama.
You miss Obama. No, I'm playing. That's a different conversation. Keep going, please.
Please give me your black card right now.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Revoked. But anyway, if you go through your Instagram feed, you'll see places everyone's going. You know, back in the day, everyone and their mother was going to Cuba. And then, you know, Trump made some changes and it's kind of slowed down, but you still can't go, though people think you can't go. then you start seeing, you know, people going to Iceland after Beyonce and Jay-Z were there. And then people were going to Cartagena, people were going to Bali. And like Bali right now is actually probably one of the top places people are going right now. And it's definitely beautiful. It's hot. It's cheap. The ticket may be a little expensive to get there, but once you're there, I think it's, you know, really relatively cheap. Like you can get a pretty decent sized villa with a pool for like under $100. So keep that in mind.
Yeah, you can't beat that. All right, so I see my main man just came into the Zoom. Shout out to Terry and Shea Butter, like, whoa.
My birthday twin. Yeah, our birthdays are coming up, by the way. Just keep in mind.
What, 11th or something like that?
Yes, we are, both of us are accepting gifts.
Terry, I got you. No, I'm playing. I'm joking. Of course, I got you. For real.
So other travel places, I would say I'm a beach person, and anyone knows anything about me is I love my alcohol, and I will travel for alcohol. I will travel for food, and I love a good beach. So I am in love with a lot of places, like the Azores Island in Portugal. I love Portugal in general. I think Portugal is one of those places people sleep on all the time. Cambodian islands, Maldives, Seychelles, Zanzibar. I love going to South Africa. The vibe of being in Johannesburg is just everything. I think Cartagena is a beautiful spot. There's so many places in this world. Like, I love traveling. Like, living in Italy, I was very fortunate to travel through most of Europe at a younger age. And so I've done most of Europe. I think right now I'm more into going to Africa and going to Asia. But there's so many places to go. There's so many places in the U.S. I think people slip on Puerto Rico. They go to San Juan and miss the most beautiful other parts of the island, like going to Isabela.
See, I never even heard of that.
Puerto Rico?
No. It's Puerto Rico, but the other one you just said. Like, for me, I know San Juan. I don't know anything outside of San Juan.
Yeah. If you're going to Puerto Rico, you need to get out of San Juan. There's so many beautiful. Vieques. Vieques is probably, has this beach called, the English version is Red Beach, is one of the most beautiful beaches I've ever seen in my entire life. And it's just, it's gorgeous. But people slip on it because they don't know anything about Puerto Rico. And it's like, there's so many places to go in this world, not knocking DR or Jamaica, but there's many places outside of this, you know, in the world to go to.
Mm-hmm. All right. So guys, if you're just tuning in, I'm talking to Danielle Washington. She is the CEO of Rogue Experiences and a great entrepreneur. So what you just said kind of made me think of a question I just thought of. You know, a lot of people, you know, some of the hurdles is, you know, financial. So I know, but one of the problem is a lot of people, they want to go out and they just ball out. You know, they want to go to a place just to look good on Instagram. They want to get the biggest suite at the Ritz-Carlton. You know what I mean? So like, what tips would you have if someone that, you know, may not have a huge budget, but they still have money to go. But, you know, I know you probably have some tips on just things you could do that are less expensive. You know, things you can do if you have a smaller budget, or just things if you have the budget, you can just save more money on instead of spending a whole bunch of money that you don't need to.
Yeah. So one of the things I would say is look for destinations where the dollar goes further. Again, South Africa is one of those great locations where our dollar is stronger. So I can't remember the conversion recently, but like when I used to, I'm giving an example of a place I used to go to all the time. So back in the day when Italy was on the lire before it went to the euro, like it was $1, one lire was like, when a US dollar was like 2 liras. So our dollars were double the amount. So go to places, there's so many countries where the conversion rate is really good. So your dollars actually go further because they're at a higher value. So keep that in mind as an option. Seasons where you're going, perfect example, going to somewhere like the Greek islands. Everyone wants to go to the Greek islands. People think, I'm going to go to the Greek islands and I'm going to go in June, July, August. Well, sure, you can go during those times, but it's going to be hella expensive. Now, if you go in shoulder seasons, like mid to late September and then May, your prices are going to be better. So kind of knowing the seasonality of when to go are tips I would recommend.
That is interesting. So somebody, you know, wants to contact you, they want to talk to you, they want to schedule a session, they want you to set a trip for them, you know, how can they get in contact with you? How can they connect with you?
Is this a person individually or as an entrepreneur?
Either one.
Just by email. So my email is Danielle at oh, wow, I was going to give a whole other email address, Danielle at rogueexperiences.com. It's Thursday. It's not, it's like my Monday, it feels like. Danielle at rogueexperiences.com, or you can find me at Rogue Experiences on Facebook, Instagram, which are the main places you can find me at, or just hit me or DM me.
Slide in the DM, y'all. Just slide in the DM. That's what I did. No, I'm playing.
How do you even know how we met?
At TSP.
Okay.
Yeah, at the bar in Atlanta.
Yes.
Yeah, so I remember.
The TSP after party.
Was that was just this year, wasn't it? No,
that was this year. Yeah, it was this year in January.
It seems like it was so long ago, but it was this year.
It was this year. I was like, who is this fellow who keeps talking about his book?
Me. No, I haven't read yet. Yeah, exactly.
So how about those Knicks?
Yeah, exactly. So just a few more questions before I let you get back to your busy, busy day. So, you know, I put in the title, like, all this me, you know, everything I talk about is money. That doesn't mean I'm obsessed over money. That doesn't mean I'll do anything for money. But, you know, in my opinion, money ties to damn near everything, especially when you live in America. You know, you go to the hospital, you know, you want to get seen. Yeah, you may not have to pay. Your insurance may cover it, but you ain't got no insurance. You go and get a bill. You know what I mean? You want to send your kids to a great school. You know, there may be some great public schools in your area. It may not be. You want to send them to that prestigious school. You're going to need some money. You want to go to the grocery store and you want to just get a whole bunch of groceries to feed your family. You're going to need money to pay for that. So, you know, I want to tie this all back to money. So what have you seen, like, in your personal experience where, you know, booking traveling for people, individual or group travel, you know, especially for entrepreneurs, that has actually helped them free up their mind to actually go out and make more money in their business or their life?
Well, yes, it goes back to what we talked about earlier. Like, being able to breathe and get away, it definitely will help people, you know, get more creative and come up with better ideas and have more energy to continue to grind. I would say the reason I would add travel as a business option for entrepreneurs in terms of adding retreats or group travel for their business is when you are an entrepreneur, it's been statistically shown that the best time to get people to buy your highest end offer is when you're in with them in person. And what better way to do it is when you have them away from the noise.
Damn.
Add a little beach, add some great value. You pump them up to show them how much you're an expert. You've built community, you've built the relationship, and then you hit them with your highest offer. This is why I tell people add travel. Yeah, you're like,
That's a nugget.
Your business as an option.
That is a huge nugget she just dropped. Especially for the high ticket sellers. If you're selling high ticket things, things that cost a lot of money to your clients, take them on vacation, take them to a beach, get them a few drinks, and then, like she said, hit them with that offer.
I'm not saying roofie people, so let's be real. That is not what I just said. But, you know, it when you do retreats, you do group travel experiences, you get them away. A, they're away from the noise, but B, they also are, it's also quantifying you as an authority figure. And so, you know, gives you more respect in what you're doing as an expert in leadership. They have questions about what you're talking about, whatever. You have the time to curate the situation to be able to, when you are ready to make that offer, you've already kind of gone through any pain points that they may have that would negate them from buying your main offer. So it gives you a chance to give them more information, kind of work through any pain points that they may have about trying to buy your offer. And it sets the tone of an amazing life to just travel around. And if, especially one of the things I was telling one of my clients is if your clients are actually, if it's like a business related thing. So say you were a doctor and you're bringing other physicians, whatever, you can have your clients let them know that this is a write-off. So not only are they getting great information from you, are they only going on a quasi vacation, but they're also can write off the trip because it is a business expense to come out and get information from you. So it's a win-win for both you and your clients.
Wow. You just dropped some nuggets. Like, you got me thinking, like, Wow. For real. Now I'm about to change my whole business approach. Honestly.
Well, let me know when you're ready to add a, you know, group trip to what you do. We can work together. So that's what I do. I help people figure out what it is that, like, where's the best place to go? Because not every destination is the right destination for everyone else, but also figuring out, like, how to budget for the trip and how to also profit from that. And then also doing the event planning. So the people who are organizing it can focus on the content and not try to do the event planning, the destination travel, booking the travel, the accommodations, all stuff like that. They focus only on the content and I focus on everything else so they can make that money.
Yeah, I definitely will be talking to you offline about that very soon. And I think that relates to something that, like, I've been saying, and I just think about it more and more and more. You know, a lot of us, like, we need to become business owners. You know, we need to become entrepreneurs. Now, entrepreneurship, of course, is not for everybody, you know, but at the same time, if you're not an entrepreneur, you're just missing out on so many opportunities that exist, especially in the country that we live in. You know, you just talked about the write-offs and the tax breaks. You know what I mean? Being able to be your own boss, being able to have your own schedule. Like, I remember, you know, when I still worked my 9-to-5, like, literally having to ask someone to take off time to be able to take a vacation there, go spend time with your family, whatever the case may be. Like, that alone used to literally get me fed up. Like, that used to seriously get me fed up, like, going to have to ask someone and then, like, oh, well, you're not approved, so I'm still going to take the time off. Well, now it's unscheduled, and now you're going to, you know, get called into a meeting and stuff like that. It's like, listen.
It's modern day slavery.
You're right. Like, literally. This is not to knock anybody who works in corporate America. Listen, I did it for years. You got to do what you got to do. But at some point, you need to make a decision. You need to make a decision. Now, listen, if you love your job, if you love what you do, that's great. But at the same time, like, if you want to do things, you want to do things on your own terms, you got to make a decision. You got to make it happen. There are communities out here you can be a part of. There are people you can connect with. There's influencers, coaches, there's consultants. There are people that will help you get into that journey. But you got to make the decision.
Also a thing about becoming a digital nomad. I mean, I know you're not there yet due to other situations, but that lifestyle is everything. Being able to know that you can travel and still work as an entrepreneur in different countries. Like, I love that I can pick up my laptop and head off to Bali. I can head off to, you know, wherever I want to go. But there's obviously ways to go about doing that to make sure that your business is still thriving. You can't just go, I'm going away and whatever, you know, set expectations with who you work with, setting hours. There's all these different things that kind of come into play that will make sure that you are more efficient in that aspect. But I love the lifestyle of living in digital nomad. It helps me live my passion, which is travel, and also be able to make sure I'm making money with my business.
Right. And, you know, that is funny. Like me, I'm not a digital nomad yet.
Yet.
But I have positioned my business in a way where as though I could be. Yep. You know what I mean? So I could be anywhere as long as I have Wi-Fi and I can still run my business. I can still, you know, have meetings, you know, have client meetings and still do what I need to do without having to physically be in a location. You know, of course, ain't nothing wrong with that. My man, Terry O'Hare, he has a huge facility, great location. He's doing 10 times more, you know, numbers than I'm doing, you know, but at the same time, I tell people, you know, if you're just starting out, if, you know, I mean, you want to leave your corporate job, whatever the case may be, the digital landscape that we currently live in allows you to start a business, get an idea, get something up and running like that with a very low barrier entry, you know, and that's something that, you know, a lot of people, you know, that I've talked to and just see, like, they don't necessarily always understand that fully. It's like, you know, back in the day, and, you know, I ain't that old, but back in the day, you want to start a business, you know what I mean? You damn near had to have a brick and mortar location. So you had to go pay rent, get a lease somewhere. You know, if you want to advertise, we're talking about, you know, newspaper, we're talking about radio ads were expensive. We're talking about TV ads were expensive. But nowadays, with softwares like ClickFunnels or Shopify or the whatever other software you want to use for your business, you could have a product to market in about 24 hours and you can have instantly traffic or whatever to your website just like that. So my point is take advantage of the landscape that we live in. Okay. Thoughts?
I agree. That almost was amen. You did not hear me amening you over there. I'm like, yes. I'm like, it's logical. Like this is the time. before regulations change, before social media changes, this is the time to jump on the bandwagon. We missed the bandwagon in blogging. This is the digital entrepreneur bandwagon, and it is the time to jump is now.
Right.
Not tomorrow, but now.
Right. And it doesn't matter like what you sell or what you do or what you want to give to the world. You just got a message that you want to give to the world and you say, listen, I don't even have a product. I don't have a service. I just have a message I want to get out to the people. You have social media channels. You can use that. And then you can package that into a course, into a training, whatever it is, a book, get it transcribed. You don't want to write a book, just, you know, do a whole bunch of videos and get it transcribed. Mm-hmm. So, you know what I mean? There's no excuses. So whatever you want to do, you got to go out and do it.
I mean, mindset is a huge part of that. Right. And, you know, you obviously, I don't know your full background, but I would say you seem like you're like, you came up with the right mindset right away. Some of us, it takes a little bit longer, but it's like, you got to start somewhere.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, for me, like when it comes to mindset with business stuff, like that's because just in my life, like, I've just been already through so much stuff, so much bullshit. You know what I mean? So when it comes to business stuff, it's like, listen, this stuff is easy. You know what I mean? Like, this stuff is like easy. Like all the stuff I've been through and hurdles and stuff I had to go through is like business stuff. If my, you know, ad doesn't run well, you know, whatever, if I don't sell my product or service, yeah, I'll be upset. But at the same time, like, it's not really that much of a big deal compared to other things I've been through. Yeah. So, you know, of course, we got to let you get back to your very busy day. Thank you for coming on. But the last question I just have for you is just talk about the importance of like networking and building relationships. Especially in your business, I know that's definitely been crucial. You know, you go on her page, y'all, she got these group trips. They doing secret society type trips and getaways. And I don't know what they be doing on these secret, you know, secret society trips, but just talk about that, you know, the importance of networking and connecting with people and just, you know, how that plays into all of everything that we've been talking about.
So for the record, there's no secret society.
I don't know.
It is just, so the trips you're looking at are all women of color. That's a secret society. There's a lot of us in the secret society. Networking is important, especially in the travel industry. For me, everything's about connection. I think everything you do is about creating events is really about creating an experience, and creating experience is all about connecting. You're connecting with your audience, you're connecting with your vendors. When you have a better relationship with people and you understand what you're doing, where you're going, all the little details that go into it, it just creates a better experience. So for me, my background is in politics. I used to work, you know, I've done events with the President of the United States, the First Lady. It's all about building the right connections to create something beautiful. And that's
Yes. Pause real quick. You did beat this up with who?
So clearly someone didn't read my bio.
I read the short one. You said you done stuff with presidents and first lady?
Yeah, so in my previous lifestyle, in doing events in different situations, I've worked with the President of the United States. I've done stuff for vice presidents. I've worked with celebrities. I've worked a little bit of everything.
Wow. Yeah, I didn't know all that. I didn't. All right, Terry says, which one?
Clinton. So did something with Clinton, Hillary, and Gore.
Okay.
So back in the day was something I just did. And so again, it's all about connections, but also getting clients is about connections. Right. When I quit my corporate job, one of my first clients, someone who referred me to someone else. This other company wanted to bring 180 people to Puerto Rico for a Cinev sales experience. And so group trip that, you know, I'm like, I wouldn't have got if it wasn't for the connection. So in this day and world, everything you do is about connection. People buy not because they like your name, not necessarily because we like what you do. It's because they like you. They like your connection. It's about building relationships. Everything in life is about relationships.
Mm-hmm.
Everything. I mean, that's how we met.
Right. Definitely. Definitely been a great relationship, great friendship, great partnership. You know, we work together. We do things together. So Jabil.
More together.
Said what?
So we'll be doing more together.
Yeah, of course. Absolutely. So Jabil says, hello, just tuning in. All right, how you doing, brother? So if anybody has any last burning questions, feel free to answer. We've been talking a lot today about mindset. you know, why you in your life or your business, you need to unplug. You need to be able to get away. You need to be able to build relationships. At the end of the day, you need to make sure traveling is a priority. Traveling should be a priority because, you know, you can definitely get caught up in life. Because me, like I said earlier, I can get so much caught up in life. And then once I'm traveling, once I'm away, and once I come back, you know, it's a whole new mindset. It's a breath of fresh air, and it just keeps me going. So drop your website and your email address again so people can get in contact with you if they need to.
Okay. In which one, the Facebook or? Okay, so I will definitely do that. But one thing I would say, point out, yes, you need to travel. Travel is important. I feel like especially in, and I'm not hating on men per se, because I'm not, but for women, I see your face before you go there. But as for women, we do so much for everyone else that we feel guilty. Like, I don't know if a guy, do you feel guilty about taking a break?
I mean, I don't.
See?
I don't.
So, but for a lot of women, we feel guilty about taking the time away from our family, from our business, from our children, to just take time for ourselves. Like, one of the things I always ask my clients is, like, if you created a priority list, would you even put your own name on it? And if you did, how long would it take you to actually put your name, like how far down would you be? Right. So that's why trips and taking that, whether it's a trip, even it could be a staycation sometimes, mm-hmm. but you need that pause in life as an entrepreneur to continue to grow and be stronger for the people who you serve.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, thank you so much for taking time out of your very busy schedule to share this information with these people. Also, if you watch this on replay, do me a favor, y'all, just type replay, type your name, where you're from. If you are a business owner, feel free to drop your link in there. I am Ryan McCrary. And also for people that are interested in becoming entrepreneurs, you want to be an entrepreneur, you know, you want to jump into this pool, for this weekend only, you can get a half off a consultation with me, private consultation. We can talk about your business goals. I can give you resources and access to my network. Whatever you want to talk about, you have access 50% off only this weekend. I never do this. This is only this weekend, only for people that are serious. I'll drop the link in there. But last word, we'll go to you.
What?
You get the last word. Take it.
My out. Last word?
Yeah.
Oh, if I could just pick the last word. This was hella dope. Hella dope.
We don't say that in these parts. We say, all right, that was thorough. You know what I mean? Like, that was thorough. But
spell it.
I can't.
My point taken. It was hella dope.
Yeah, this is definitely hella dope. So make sure you connect with her. We're going to put her link in there. You can also email her at Danielle@RogueExperiences.com. Danielle@RogueExperiences.com. And I'll be back tomorrow at the same time. Got a special guest for y'all, somebody who's on here right now. We got Shea Butter Like Whoa coming through tomorrow at the same time. So make sure y'all tune in. This will be a great conversation talking about
how he's having all the birthday twins at the same time, back to back. I love this.
Back to back. And, you know, I don't know who we're going to have after that. Talked to Dante earlier, so Dante might have to be next. But yeah, definitely. RogueExperiences.com. To go to RogueExperiences.com. So if you know you want to book a solo travel or a group travel, anything to do with traveling, make sure you contact Danielle. Great information, great nuggets, especially for entrepreneurs. You know, going to a trip, and you know, this is the last thing I'll say. You know, what if you could go and have a lavish vacation, have a great trip, and all that could be written off of your business? Oh, you know, it's all about changing the dynamic and changing the mindset. So when I first started my business, that's what I had to literally do. I had to literally change my mindset and just shift it and say, like, all right, you know, you're always talking about going out to eat or even Starbucks. Well, you go there and you meet somebody, you know, for a meeting. Now I can write that off. So now I'm not just being a consumer. You know, now I can write that off. Now if I take a trip, I can write that off. You know, certain things that I go and travel to, if I'm just driving, I can write off. So definitely want to think about being a business owner. Also, she dropped the link to her private Facebook group. But at the end of the day, just make it a priority. Make things happen. And everybody have a great, great weekend. But I'll be back tomorrow with my man, Terry from Shea Butter Like Whoa. Y'all have a great afternoon.
Ciao.